In what time will rupees 1000 become rupees 1331 at 10% per annum compounded annually? Okay, look at the board. Very good question. It's a very good question. Now in this question, what is given to you? What is given to you? It mentioned that in what time, aapko time nikalna hai, will rupees 1000 become 1000 jo hai wo 1331 jata hai, compounded annually, compounded as a question hai. To aapko P de rakha hai, P value kitni hai? 1000. Okay. कितना हो जाता है कम्युलेटेड अमाउंट 1331 हो जाता है कितने टाइम में हो जाता है क्या n मेंशन है n निकालना है मुझे r गिवन है क्या यस 10% पर एनम ओके सो हाउ यू अप्रोच दिस काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन सो व्हाट इज योर a वैल्यू माय a वैल्यू इज व्हाट p 1 plus r डिवाइड बाय 100 रेज टू द पावर n सो दिस इज द फार्मूला बेसिक फार्मूला आई एम गोइंग टू अप्लाई ओवर हियर व्हाट इज योर a वैल्यू इज गिवन टू यू 1331 is equal to p value is 1000, 1 plus r is 10, divide by 100, raised to the power and need to find out, okay? Now, this value gone, 10 when the 10 plus 1, 11 by 10, I'll divide this term also, 331 divided by 1000 is equal to 11 by 10 raised to the power n. If such question comes, how you calculate this n value? Those students who are good in math, they know whenever the power terms come into the picture, you need to convert the opposite side in the power term. So when you convert the opposite side, the raised to power, some power which is having the same value of this, you just consider this value as a base. So if I multiply 11 into 11, what value I will get. So suppose 11 multiplication, you just put left this, 10 multiply by 10 give you 100, and if you multiply again 10, you will get 1000, no problem. So I know 10 to the power 3 gives you 1000. So can 11 raised to the power 3 give you 1331? Just check. So 11 multiply by 11, 11 multiply by 11, you will get 121. You will get 121. And further, if you multiply this value by 11, will you get this value? Yes. You will get 1331. 1331. 1331. It means this value is what? This value is what? 11 by 10 raised to the power 3 is equal to 11 by 10 raised to the power n. Now, whenever base is same, you can equate power also. This is the rule of mathematics. Whenever the base is same, you can equate the power. And from equating the power, I will get n equal to 3. N equal to 3. So, as per the knowledge of your mathematics, you can calculate the n value by equating the power. The basic idea for this question is, whenever you need to calculate the number of year, such type of problem comes to you. So always keep in your mind, whenever n is going to calculate in compound interest equation, in compound interest problem, so you can apply such kind of method to calculating n value. Okay, so this is the third question. Now move to the next question. It's also very important. In this question, if rupees 500 amount, if rupees 500 amount to rupees 583.20 in 2 years, 2 साल में 500 जो है वो बढ़कर 583 हो जाता है. Compounded annually, find the rate of interest per annum. तो आपको क्या निकालना है? आपको निकालना है rate की value निकालनी है. यहाँ पे आपको rate निकालना है. Okay sir, no problem at all. तो कैसे करेंगे? Principal value किसने दे रखी है? तो sir principal value दे रखी है 500. कितना हो जाता है 583.20 जो मेरा अमाउंट है वो रहता है 583.20 ये पी वैल्यू है ये ए वैल्यू है ओके और रेट दे रखा है क्या रेट निकालना है एन दे रखा है क्या यस एन दे रखा है टू ईयर दे रखा है एक बार देखिए जरा क्वेश्चन में यस दे रखा है आपको रेट निकालना है और ये दे रखा है टू ठीक है तो ये फॉर्मूला है बेसिक फॉर्मूला इज रिमेन सेम Now I am going to calculate R value by putting all these values in this basic equation 583.20 0.20 is equal to 500. 1 plus R value is what? R is need to calculate, divide by 100 raised to the power 2. Okay, we just divide this term. 583.20 divided by 500 is equal to 1 plus R by 100 raised to the power 2. Okay, fine. So what you have to do is you just divide this term. 583.20 divide this value by 500. So you will get how much? 1.1664 is equal to 1 plus R divided by 100 raised to the power 2. Now this is square. Now take the root of this, you will get 1 plus R by 100. So 1 plus R by 100 is equal to root of 1.1664. So I'm taking the root of this value, root of this answer. So you will get 1.08. So 1 plus R by 100 is equal to 1.08. So what is R by 100? So my R by 100 is 1.08 minus 1. So R by 100 is equal to 0.08. So what is R value? Cross multiply, you will get 8%. You will get 8%. So this is the problem. This is the problem of a different kind where you need to calculate R. In the previous problem where you calculate the n value, and then time you use the power method to calculate n. Whenever R values come, you need to take square root of value. The power interest question comes, you need to calculate n value. There is a power method used. This is how you calculate n value, R value, a value in compound interest. And some mixed problem which I am going to discuss in the next lecture video. That whenever the mixed problem comes of simple interest, compound interest, both are in the same problem, how you calculate compound interest. Thank you so much for watching this video.